Hello, ladies and gentlemen, this is BestInSlot, and welcome back to Jurassic World Evolution 2. And tonight, we're going to take a look at the weirdest mod I've ever seen in this game, or in the other game as well. This is weird stuff. So what we're going to check out today is Stegolf, made by, of course, Kyo Denik, who always brings us that super weird stuff. And I'm going to show you this in a very basic way, first of all, and then we're going to go try an actual course out. So Stegolf is what it says on the tin. It's a golf mini game somehow in Jurassic World Evolution 2. So if you install the mod, you'll find out on the Nexus, but I'll link it down below as well. And then you load into the game and hit V, you'll see that we get a whole new menu of hit settings, clubs, drivers, stuff like that. We'll get into that in just a second. What you'll also see, and I should have done this first, if you go into enclosures, you get this new stuff over here. Now the important ones are the Stegolf hole, which, as you see there, so that is our hole. That's where we're trying to get the Stegolf ball into. And if we come over here, we can also have a spawner, which you'll see, if I then activate the spawner, will spawn a Stegolf ball. Basically, you see that Stegolf spawner 3, Stegolf hole 3. That means that when the Stegolf ball goes into the hole, it should, in theory, work. So that's how you spawn your Stegosaurus, your Stegolf ball, and go from there. And there's lots of other things. I'm not going to go into all this. If you want to see all the details, Kyle's got like a 20-minute long video where it goes into excruciating depth about how the mod actually works, but it is insane. It really is. There's all these hazards. You know, if you want to... I'll just show you one of them, for example. Speed. Speed's a fairly obvious one. So if you put that there, then when your ball goes through that orb, and you can change, you know, how much it affects it, and the radius, and the taper range, and all this crazy stuff. When the ball goes through that hole, it'll then start to speed up, basically. Okay, so we're gonna hit V again, and we're gonna go into our putter driver slash club menu, let's say. So you can see we've got three different clubs. We've got a driver, a pitching wedge, and a putter. And the difference really is in how far the ball will go, and also how angled up the ball will go. For anyone who knows anything about golf, of course, you know the putter is going to stay largely around the ground. So if I just, what you do is you click on your Stego ball, you pull the mouse back, and you'll see it starts to go red. And if it gets super red like that, that means it's maximum power. So it doesn't get any stronger than that. So I'm just going to go pew, like so, as you can see. And you can set the strength and the weakness as well. And basically, that's a multiplier that applies to how far back you pull it. We've got a driver, which will lift it up into the air a little bit, as you can see. And then we've got a pitching wedge, which if you need to get over an obstacle, is what you would use, because it's really good for that. It doesn't get much distance, but it gets a lot of height. And I just think this is madness. I don't know what else to tell you. I think this is absolutely crazy. So I'm just going to try to... Oh yeah. Okay, so you can see now if we go to Stegolf Hall 3. Oh wait, do I have to activate? Am I stupid? I might be stupid. Wait, why has that not worked? I don't know why that's not worked. I've probably done something wrong. There's just one thing I want to try before we move on. So you can, just as with the custom species viewer spawner that Kyle made the other day, you can change the species and the cosmetic set and all these details, and it will actually affect how far the dinosaur goes, because, you know, a lighter dinosaur will be knocked further. So we're going to set S equals Dryo. We're going to set that to a Dryosaurus, and as you can see, it spawned now a Dryosaurus. So a teeny tiny dinosaur. We're going to hit V, we're going to go onto our driver, we're going to go to strong, we're going to aim towards the ocean, we're going to pull, wait, it's not about the mouse, it's a, oh god, oh, yeah, no, let's just reset you, shall we? There we go. So it's not about the screen, it's about the mouse. So if I just go like this, it's still going. There we go. It's a beautiful moment. I believe I can fly. And it will go out of bounds. I don't have expanded maps on, but it doesn't matter for the Dryo. So, not only can you download Stegolf Ball as a mod, but Wonders GTA, who does some fantastic map designs and we've showcased their race course things before in the past, has also made a series of maps for this mod. You can download those from the exact same page. And if we load into our sandbox maps, we should see them somewhat. Yes, so you can see that actually organized here. So golf holes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And these are organized in difficulty. So it starts off with the easy ones. So we're just going to give it a go. I've never done this before. I don't have much experience with this, but I'm curious to see how they've laid these holes out. You can do lots of tricky things as well, like some of the hazards are like force, where it pushes out from the center of the ball. So if you hit just the golf ball to like the right hand side of it, it'll curl around. It's really interesting. Okay, this is scary. Where's... Oh, that is the hole. Oh, wow, okay. I'm assuming that kind of like... I don't want to say the words, but I'm assuming that kind of like sucks it in. Yeah, intensity minus one, that means it pulls towards the middle. So the goal is to get it into here. So we need to get to there. Okay, cool. Right, let's just give this a go. I'm going to stick with the Stego. It's all been very beautifully set up. And first things first, we're just going to warm this up. I don't know how far this goes. Let's find out. Okay, I clearly made a mistake. Right, let's set that to strong. Let's try this again. Okay, there we go. I'm watching you, Diplo. Okay, so that's the driver. Now the putter, I think the putter might get more... similar distance. To avoid the sand trap, I'm just going to try to... Oh god, it's going to be a rough one. Okay, okay, this seems good. Okay, so now we need a pitching wedge. Oh no, we don't. We need to get over there, don't we? Okay, so there's another thing as well. Water is a soft reset. If you land in the water, can I just point out, how on earth has this been made? This is madness to me. This is genuine, utter madness. Like, it's just such nonsense. But if just the golf ball hits the water, it'll reset to its old position. Ah, and as was also mentioned, these concrete walls, these ones here, if the golf ball goes over one of these walls, it also resets. So you can never aim this way. You do have to go around to the right. Okay, I think a driver should be fine here. I'm gonna go big, big, big swing. Eh. Go on, buddy. Good lad. Right. Are we close enough to get in there from here? Let's find out. Let's find out. Let's go for it. Eh. Go on. Go on, Stegolf. Go on. I think we did it. Get in there. Success! Sweet. And then you see the hole has activated. That's what's meant to happen. Unfortunately, I was 3 over par. Par was 4 for that. So, let me see if that makes sense. 1. Yeah, I think you can probably do it in 3 maybe, but like 1, 2, 3, 4. It's definitely doable. But not bad. Not bad for my first go. How cool is that though? I think that's incredible. The map is really well made and of course... right, okay. So, going round... down the bend, and then, okay, this one looks pretty simple. What's par? Par is 5. Okay, why is par 5? It seems quite an easy one. Maybe it's gonna trick me somehow. There are a lot of concrete barriers around the outside, so we'd have to be a little bit careful. I'm gonna go again for a strong driver. I wonder if you could chip over the wall. And that might be a viable tactic. Eh. Go on, Stego. Go on, Stego. Tell you what, there's a distance on it, isn't there? You can see that sometimes it's red. That means it's not able to be played with at that point in time. And, Oh, I might get par here. I might get under par, actually. I might just get under par. I just need one big hit. I think I might go for the putter. I don't know. I get the feeling that the putter's, like, super strong. Eh. No! No, so close. So close, well, not that close. I mean, in theory, the putter would not be the one you'd use in this situation. You'd use the driver. But there we go, not bad. I got par. Okay, that's an improvement. Alright, let's move on. Oh, no. Oh, no. Okay, what's par on this one? Par is 3. That's a bit harsh, isn't it? What have we got? We've got Spinosauruses walking around underneath as well. So yeah, I mean, shout out to Kyle for an incredible mod, but also shout out to Wonders GTA for making these really, really cool maps. Okay, I need to make sure. No, I didn't mean to do that. I didn't mean to click. Oh no. Oh no, I've just wasted a shot. Okay, pretend I didn't do that shot. I was just testing out the water mechanic. See. Oh. Right. Okay. It's about directionality as well. So I want to make sure I'm going like. Well, where do I want to go? I want to go like there. I think. Eh! Fly, my pretty, fly! It's not gonna make it. It's nowhere near making it. Right, interesting. Okay, so that went to there. I mean, this is full strength, so I'm a little surprised by that. Do I put over? I think I'm missing something. I feel like the driver is the right one. Let me just try again. Make sure I am maximum strength. Right, that it can't get stronger than that. I'm missing something. Yeah, so I don't know. I'm clearly missing a trick somewhere. Ah, you know what it is. I know exactly what the problem is. I can't believe I've only just remembered this. So how far? Oh, this is exactly what it is, right? How far the ball goes is tied to your frame rate. Okay. So because that's just like that's not a Kaio thing. That's just something in Frontier's physics engine, and a lot of game physics are tied to frame rates. There's problems in like Dark Souls, for example, wherein your weapon would degrade faster if you had a higher frame rate because it feels like there's more points of contact or whatever. The point is, it's tied to your frame rate. Now my frame rate, I'm on max settings, but my frame rate is still really good. It's in the hundreds, right? So if your frame rate is higher, the ball doesn't go as far. So what you would need to do, if after setting all your settings to max, as you can see, you would have to, I guess, if you wanted to play this, you would have to find a frame rate limiter, really. If your PC isn't mine's a bit of a monster. I only got it fairly recently, so it's quite strong, very modern. If your PC is a bit older, you should have no problem with a lot of these maps. It'll be less hard work for you. It's a bit of a shame for me. I will have to find a external program. I don't know if NVIDIA GeForce things do it, but maybe there's an external thing I can find to limit my frame rate. I don't think Evolution itself offers it, but my frame rate is basically nearly double the 60, so of course the ball isn't going nearly as far. That's why it's such hard work. I don't just suck. Fantastic. But anyways, credit to Kyodenic for making literally the craziest mod I've ever seen in Jurassic World Evolution 1 or 2. It is mad what has been done here. I think that really is the only way to put it, surely. It's utter craziness. It's just insane. It really, really is. I cannot get over how this has been done. And for something so stupid as well. I really appreciate that. And shout out to Wonders GTA. I will link their channel down below as well. If you want to check out their videos. And of course, check out this map section, which, yeah, the maps are fine. The maps are brilliant. They're really well made. You can tell there's loads and loads of hours in there. And they're really, really cool. I wish I could play them properly, but maybe one day in the future. Either way, I just want to showcase the mod, recommend it to you folks at home if you want to do something a little bit mad with your time. Right, thank you very much for joining me. I'll see you lovely folks very soon. Throw me a like down below if you enjoyed the video. Remember to check out Kaio's Nexus mod page and Wonder's video, and also Kyle's video as well. Cheers, much love, as always. Bye-bye. Reaching out.